Can I use Latisse or Lumigan drops to make my eye bag smaller? I read an article that the main ingredient in Lumigan shows promising results in non-surgical blepharoplasty eye bags removal. Can I use topical Lumigan drops under eyes to reduce eye bags? Thank you.
Thank you for your question. You're asking an interesting question. You're asking if you can use Lumigan to help reduce the size of your under eye bags. Well, this is a very interesting question. Just to give you a little bit of background, I'm a board certified cosmetic surgeon and a fellowship trained oculofacial plastic surgeon specializing in eyelid cosmetic surgery, and the base specialty prior to oculoplastic surgery is ophthalmology, so I'm also trained in eye surgery and very familiar with drugs for ocular management such as Lumigan. So I'll give you a little bit of background for you in terms of the science and help you understand whether or not it's a viable use for under eye bags. So to begin with, Lumigan is a what's called a prostaglandin analog, which helps people who have glaucoma, which is an increased pressure, or for lay people, it's effectively is a disease that is causes the optic nerve to slowly decrease in its strength and its volume to the point where you lose vision. And in that field of glaucoma management, treating pressure has been shown to have an impact on the progression of glaucoma. So Lumigan actually affects the eye, is intended to affect the eye by allowing the aqueous humor, or the fluid that creates the pressure in the eye, to drain faster. Well, of course, side effects from Lumigan were shown to result in eyelashes getting longer, and so Lumigan was then rebranded under the trade name Latisse. So it actually is used to help people have longer eyelashes. Now, another side effect has been documented, and actually it's more diffused than what you're describing. You have to understand that even though you may put the drops into the eye like a regular eye drop, the drops get absorbed, and they get absorbed by the eye, they get absorbed by the conjunctiva or the tissue around the eye. And so the literature has shown a loss of volume in the upper lid, it's shown a loss of volume of the eye muscles. And so basically I think the point that I'm making is there is potential for undesirable effects that can be problematic. People who are on these drops are on these drops for long term. Glaucoma is a chronic disease. The time frame in which you would need to use the eye drop to cause this volume loss is not going to be predictable. In addition, if it's affecting not only the fat under the eye, but the fat above the eye and the eye muscles, then you are dealing with essentially a toxicity. And on top of that, all eye drops, especially drops that are used for therapeutic purposes, in and of themselves, because of preservatives and other things, can have toxicities. And these drops were designed to get absorbed by the eye. So you're not, I can't say for certain what kind of impact it would have on your ocular health. The mechanism of action is too complex to discuss in terms of for the lay public, but basically the only way currently that it can be used to try to help this area would be through an eye drop delivery system. Now, could there be possibility the use of injectable in the future? Possible, but I think that as a surgeon who works in this area every day, I can tell you that it is very tricky to inject into this space and not potentially have a problem with of something that is vision-threatening. There, for years, people have tried different injectable things, such as something like a phosphatidylcholine or other drugs that can help melt fat. But when you're talking about working around the eye, you are dealing with a very delicate structure, and you can have much more significant problems. So I would advise against the use of Lumigan by somebody who is not diagnosed and is not being treated for glaucoma because of the inability to be precise with it, as well as all the potential side effects and other problems that can occur. If you have under-eye bags that are problematic, in our practice, we're able to take care of this in less than an hour under local anesthesia with light sedation. So even though people aren't enamored by the idea of surgery, if you think about it, something that's much more controlled, like surgery, and has a beginning and an end, once you do it, it's done. You're not dealing with management. So it's a way to think about it, and of course, understanding this side effect and the potential problems with using a drug for something that may not be predictable, I would advise against it. So I hope that was helpful. I wish you the best of luck, and thank you for your question.